Many people start their day with different things on their mind, like what to wear, check their social media, work, and how much money they can make. Not putting God first, and suddenly, in a moment, they will die, and the people will be troubled at midnight and pass away, and the mighty will be taken away without a hand. This is why you need the midnight prayer.
Very good morning to you. It's now 0:03. I'm here with Pastor Junior, and we are going to be praying for you. We are in this purpose of faith because we are fighting against depression. Reason why we are dressed with this green shirt, because green is the color that represents our fight against depression. We know very well that most people nowadays, they are suffering with depression and they do not know. They cannot realize. They are depressive. They have, you know, depressive moods, as we spoke yesterday. And they don't know that the cause of those mood swings is but depression. And some others, they have other symptoms, as we are going to be speaking about this hour, this morning. Pastor Junior, how many people they are watching us, they have a relative, a family member, a colleague at work, that they are depressed and they don't know?
And most of the time, the family member, they try their best to help them, but they cannot. And you see that depression, Pastor Max, is a silent killer that have been killing so many people all over the world. And it is something that many people, they don't want to talk about. But we have been seeing many people losing lives because of that, and they don't know what to do to reverse that situation. But here in the Universal Church, we have the antidote to help those who have been facing depression. We know we can help them.
And one of the signs of this depression is sleep changes. The person changes the night for the day, and others, they change the day for the night. There are people that they cannot close their eyes. They can't sleep. They are 24 hours a day stressed, overwhelmed, filled with anxiety. And yet there are others that they can do absolutely nothing. They are constantly sleeping. They sleep throughout the night. They don't have the strength to do anything throughout the day. They just want to be on bed. Mm-hmm. They don't take shower. They don't eat. They don't socialize. They don't interact with people. This is also a sign of a depressive person.
Exactly. They lock themselves in a dark room and they lost the appetite to do something else. Many people, Pastor Marcos, they prefer, for days, better to stay sleepy, because for some of them is to ease up the pain. Because whenever they are awake during the day, whenever they are at home or at work, some people, they feel that unbearable pain. It's like that mother who lost her son, or that person who lost a family member. And whenever the person remembers about him or her, the person starts to feel depressed, the person starts to feel down. And many others, they feel comfortable to sleep, because when they sleep, they don't think about the problem. Then it's like a ease up the pain that they feel. But we know that sleep change is also a symptom of depression.
So, my friend, perhaps you have this symptom which we have disclosed. Reason why we have here the bottle of water. We are praying for this water. We are blessing this water every single day. First hour of the day, first minute of every new day, as we are here now past midnight, we are blessing this water and leading you to take a sip of it. And we are going to be doing so until Saturday. Better saying, Sunday, the first hour of the day. Because we are preparing ourselves for the great day that we are going to put an end to all depression, which is going to be the 11th of October. In these 2 weeks, or better saying, in these 13 days that we have ahead of us, we are going to be working. We are going to be determined, focusing, targeting the end of all depression, 11th of October. October will be the day.
The international day that we are going to beat the depression. And it is poor that they are going to see throughout of this week, not only an improvement, but a great change. All that they have to do is to follow the direction that we have been given here. Because while we have thousands and thousands of people with depression all over the world, we also have people that they have been taking this spiritual treatment and they have been overcoming depression.
I would like you to have a bottle of water for yourself and also a bottle of water for someone, a friend, a relative, a family member. You are going to offer this bottle of water that we are going to pray for. Pastor Junior will be praying for the water that God may bless it. And I'll be praying for the nation. So we are going to bless this water for you. The water that is yours, after the prayer, you're going to take a sip of it. And the other bottle of water, you're going to offer to someone who keep on saying to you, I can't sleep. Or someone that keep on saying to you, I don't have strength to do nothing. I want to be on bed all day long because there is too much happening in my life and I don't know how to handle it. So you are going to offer this bottle of water to this person. And you are going to advise this person to get connected with us today, 5 o'clock in the morning or 8 o'clock in the evening, as we are going to have the miracle service, the powerful gathering of faith that God is going to work healing in your life. Pastor Junior will say the prayer.
Please close your eyes. Our Lord and our Father, God of the Bible, you are capable, you are able to help those who are depressed. My Lord, there are many people going through this depression for so many years. Some people, Lord, they cannot sleep during the night at all. Some others, they can. They stay the whole day sleeping. They lock themselves in a dark room. They don't want to talk to nobody. There are many people, Lord, that they have been trying medications. They have been taking tablets. They have been trying their best to overcome depression. And up to now, all their tries, it was unsuccessful. And my Lord, I ask you for you to consecrate, for you to sanctify, for you to bless this water that this person is holding in their hands. For when this person drink of this water, my Lord, let your power to take place inside of this person's heart, inside of this person's mind, to remove, my Lord, all this depression, all this sadness, this low self-esteem, these suicidal thoughts. My God, I ask you, help this person. Do for him, for her, what the tablet, the medication could not do up to now. From the room of the Holy Spirit, we consecrate this water. We bless this water. And the friends that will take this water, drink from the other bottle of water, that friend as well will recover, will be okay, will overcome the depression. My God, I surrender this purpose that we are doing here with this water into your mighty hands.
So it is, oh Father. Likewise, we determine healing upon our land, Trinidad and Tobago. We determine, my Father, that prosperity may be upon our land. Your light may shine upon every citizen and immigrant. Bless our leaders, our governors, the authorities of our nation. Bless the youths. Bless, oh Father, those who are working very hard to make Trinidad and Tobago a better place every day. Stop the violence. Stop the crime, the murders. My Father, I ask you, bring peace upon our land. I entrust Trinidad and Tobago into your hands. I ask you, bless the economy of our nation. Bless the public sector, the private sector, every businessman and woman, all entrepreneurs, all employees and employers of this country. Oh God, I surrender all to you, and with a blessing I determine Trinidad and Tobago and all the other people of different, my Father, nations that now pray with us, blessed for the honor and the glory of your name. And those who agree and believe say, amen. My friend, you are blessed indeed. Pastor Junior, tonight at 8 p.m. we are going to be together because we have 12 pastors ministering healing to the nation.
Exactly, Pastor Marco is a team of pastors with the authority that the Lord Jesus gave to us for us to be determining your cure, your healing. That's why if you have any kind of sickness, infirmity, if you have been doing a health treatment, don't forget to stay with us tonight, 8 p.m. because we pastors, we are going to be determining your healing.
I'll be with you 5 a.m. with the workers' prayer. And don't forget, 11th of October. 11th of October, the International Day Against Depression. You will see that until then, in these days we have ahead of us, every sip you take of the water we are blessing is going to bring you inner healing, inner cure. And when the 11th come, you will no longer be a victim of this evil that has been destroying so many people's lives. As for me and Pastor Junior, arise and shine. Be blessed. Together, we are strong.
I was living in a life of addiction, drinking, gambling. The worst part in my life was my relationship with my wife. I tried to find happiness because I was causing the problem between me and my wife. My marriage was just about to break. My eyes were lost in pornography. So that's why our relationship between my wife, I was living in a life of betrayal. The word in my mouth, I love my wife. But in deeply inside, I didn't. Because I betrayed her. I commit adultery. I forgot the relationship between me and her. Our marriage was destroyed because what was addiction in me was pornography. And I used to drink and also make drugs, smoke. And we make party. Every time when I finish from work, I'm not going straight home. After work, we find somewhere else. We make party in the night until in the morning, I just go home. I was drinking too much. I spent $200 a week, plus more, it's nearly $300 a week. I was greedy to continue and continue. And that's why my addiction is growing and I can't stop. My wife asked me and then I said no money. And then we start arguing. When the addiction was too much, that misleading my mind from my wife. Now I want to leave my wife. My mind was so attracted to other friends. We also fight. One day I keep hiding my wife. That was my big problem. My children knows me. If I'm angry, there's no one come beside me. They know me. If I'm drunk, there's no one come beside me because I keep them hiding so much, too much, and they run away. They're so scared of me. So this is a point that I couldn't handle. I nearly lost my marriage in those days. When I came to the a treatment, and then I learned that the addictions are a spirit. And I understand this is the evil spirit that was controlling my feelings and emotional. And then I sacrificed everything. And the treatment applied in my health and in my life, the addictions removed. And then I was free. And then I free from those addictions. I didn't drink anymore. I'm not feel angry anymore. My finance is growing. And we pay bills and we use the money and our finances blessed. I haven't got any feelings of those addictions. I feel a new mind and a new life and a new relationship between me and my family and my children. I'm free. I'm free from all those addictions. No more drink, no more alcohol, no more anger. I am free now, and I am a new person now. I am free, and then it set me free.